Hi everyone, this is Matteo from the StreamYard team, and today I wanted to review with you what we've worked on these past few months and go over what's changed and what's new in StreamYard. It's gonna be a hands-on session, so we will go over each feature directly into StreamYard's UI. So let's start. So here we are in the StreamYard studio. Sounds is a feature that lets you play back simple sound effects whenever you need them during your stream. For example, if I wanted an applause effect to play back while, for example, I'm celebrating something with my viewers, I would use the applause sound effect. Thank you. We have a few sounds built in right into StreamYard, but you can even upload your own, so you will always find them right into your Media Assets tab. We wanted to make it easier to produce more structured shows, so we've introduced the Notes tab. With the Notes tab, you can jot down and save notes for each of your studios. It can be a script for your show to follow then when you're actually live. For example, I'm gonna paste here some notes that I prepared beforehand, and then I can simply apply some extra formatting while I'm here. We have a characters and a word count, and everything is saved and synced in real time. A cool thing of the Notes tab is that it's seamlessly integrated with the Teleprompter feature that lets you display your scripts slowly and gradually over the main screen. So, for example, let me turn on the teleprompter here, and you can see up here that we have a new pop-up that if I press play, it's gonna start playing back all my notes to the speed that I set it to. Speed 1 is the slowest one. There's an estimation of how much time it would take to read the whole thing, and I can increase the speed and start playing back again, which is definitely faster. This is only visible to you, and it does not affect how your audience sees the content that you put on screen. Lately, we've also focused on improving the way you organize your content on stage. First, you can now minimize or maximize any element that's displayed on stage. For example, if I click here, my camera gets minimized, and if I press again, you can see that it takes up the whole screen. Then we double the number of custom layouts that you can save to your account so that you can explore with more configurations that are specifically tailored for your streams. And finally, we release scenes for portrait mode as well. So for example, if I go into my destination YouTube here, well, right now I'm streaming to both orientations, but let's just switch to portrait for now. Save changes. My studio switches to portrait. Hi. And if I open the scenes panel here, you can see all my scenes that I previously created for landscape orientations are automatically available and adapted. So let me use this scene. You can see that I can seamlessly switch between the two scenes, like just like that. Okay, so we're back into Mars mode, and let's get right away into the Media Assets tab. You might have noticed that we have a placement option here, so if we toggle the logo, we can decide whether to show it on the left or on the right. This allows you to customize and have more freedom on whether to put something here or to put another element here and move your logo based on the positions you decide to assign to each element. Speaking of upper thirds, one way you can really maximize that real estate is to use a feature we've introduced recently, which is the QR code. QR code lets you add a QR code generated by StreamYard directly from your studio without using external tools. For example, if I type here my StreamYard QR code and I link StreamYard page, click create, it's gonna generate a QR code immediately that I can then show right into my upper third in one of the two corners of the screen. Of course, if I switch the placement of my logo, the placement of the QR code is gonna switch as well to keep your stage clean without overlaps. So what do you put in your QR code? Well, in my example here, I just put streamer.com because I'm biased, but there are different purposes you can use this feature for, and I wanted to share some of those with you. A very clever way that some of you have been using this feature is to invite guests to join your studio. So I take my streamer link and I just paste it inside here. And whenever someone scans this code now, they will be able to join my studio. Another way is to showcase their social media. For example, I can link our YouTube channel, or I can put my Facebook or even my Linktree if I have one. And finally, I can share some recommendations for my viewers, or I can quickly switch between different links to different resources that I want my viewers to be aware of when they're watching my streams. Chat overlay is something that we released back in May, and we've been thinking on how to improve upon it, also incorporating the precious feedback that you've been sharing with us. So recently we released a second iteration of it called originally Chat Overlay 2.0. So let me go into the comments tab, and since I have a destination connected, I can see the toggle here. I turn on and here's my chat overlay. And now you can see there's a settings dropdown where you can regulate the size and the fonts of the chat overlay. You can pick between regular, tall, wide, and between small, medium, and big fonts. You can also see that we've introduced question detection. So whenever someone writes a question, it's gonna be displayed in a special way in the chat overlay and also inside your main comments tab. These were just a few of the main updates that we released in the past months, but of course there's much more that I could not fit into this video. So to learn more, scan the QR code up here or click the link in the description. We post something every week, so I invite you to explore it on your own in StreamYard. See you soon!